afternoon. Oh, it's been another gorgeous day. Best laid plans I got this morning. Got a lot to do, so I've got on the go. And so away I went, road tested the stick, now repaired. But after a bit of a problem with it actually. A dull situation. Brilliant, absolutely. First class. There wasn't any real, as I said in the last video, there was a bit of the water got in, and the water certainly had got in. And it had done a little bit of damage, but the wood was still sound, it was still extremely good. The damage had been done with Elizabeth, and I told you the story of trying to break it. The son said to me that day, we were both a wonder when we met her, and she took the stick and decided to give it her test, the Elizabeth test, I think. The son said to me after, she's trying to break that stick. I says, yeah, I says, I don't like it. I says, I'll certainly try to do something with it anyway. And as I said, she's a big girl and she had done the damage. That was about a year or so ago. And, I hadn't really thought, I didn't notice that it gapped up a little bit between it, but it seemed to be all right. I never really bothered after that. I just kept using it. Try as I might, I couldn't get the dowel out. I couldn't move the screw at all, and so I ended up finding the end of it and cutting it. I'll show you what I'm talking about. And so we ended up having to cut that section off it, and so if I bring the handle down to a size, which is probably a better size now anyway though. Was it long to start with? I don't think so. But it's now shorter, obviously. We're now an inch and a quarter at least. That was about the length of the dowel, just a bit more maybe. And so we're now that little bit shorter than we were. But I've just finished sorting it off. I went to use the other stick this morning, the one that I'd been working on, and I'd kind of market stick that I had made up, and it's a nice stick. And I went to use it this morning, and your hand gets used to a stick, and I'm going to use this one because I'm going to maybe try a little bit of stain on this, and then varnish it up. I think I'll put a bit of stain on it just to dull it down a little bit, like, and then look as if I'm blind or something, white. My eyesight's not too bad yet, like, my hearing's a bit iffy, but my wife says I'm selective in my hearing. I only hear when I want to hear them, right enough, but this is, I'd varnished this one yesterday and sorted it out a little bit, and this morning was a bit tacky, and just wasn't as hard as I wanted to be. It's still not got the finish that I want, but I'll probably use it for a couple of days or so and then bring it in, and I'll see how it goes. But at the end of the day, I'm more than happy with the fact that this stick had that done to it, and she did, as I said, she did test it that day. For what reason, I'm not really sure. Like, you know, could it be the fact that I'd said that the jointing was so good, but there was that bit more length to it then, and so if you look at it like that, it doesn't do probably to have the handle at too long. You want it probably at the length it's at now, it's probably at where it should be, but when I made it that day, it just worked in fine, so I just left it that bit. It doesn't do to have the part coming down on the shank of the handle too long. So it's that kind of thing. So, but yes, it's all right, and there wasn't really any great damage water-wise or anything to it. I just let it in, and when I was trying to take the handle off, what happened actually is that it just broken. When I checked it out, there was no real rot as such. So I'm more than happy with the whole setup. As I say, you road test them anyway and give them, this as I say, gets a good hammering. So I had a weigh this morning, there was still glue protruding out here or there and whatnot, but I said, I'll take it anyway and bash it around the road. And as I said, great plans to get, I was away early this morning, I've got plans to get back there. I met a chap who kept me back. We were discussing woodpeckers and the likes of, and how the birds are now into full song just about. Meteorological first day of spring, but, and to all intents and purposes out there, it's beautiful, it really is, but the fear lies that it won't last, so we'll see how it goes. But so I thought I'd just let you see it now and confirm to this bit. It's a good stick to the hand, it's, and every stick, every hand will have a different feel to it, and what fits you won't fit somebody else, and so that was that. So I thought we'll just bring you up to the date on it. We're going to run it through, put the video on and do it all, but it was supposed to be a simple one yesterday, I went, oh dear, dear. But anyway, you have a good done. I arrived home and I found that I had a visitor. I don't get many visitors, by the way. I'm not that very social, but I don't get many visitors nowadays. Like, you know, I've worked with an awful lot of people in my time. But I think when I finish working with me, I think I've had enough of me, and they go their separate ways, and I never see them again. But this chap visits regularly. Well, on a regular, he visits on a regular, kind of, at least once a year, which is pretty good for me, like, you know. And he came bearing gifts, so. And so that was that. So by the time we'd got that finished with, what can you say, it was time for, I don't call them siestas, I don't know, Americans are power nappers, you know, they've developed the thing where you power nap and you wake up and you're completely refreshed and you're back into the groove. So it was a power nap more than anything. But I was working away on the whistles and tried a bit with the calls with the, excuse me a moment, I'm just going to puff away here. I tried a bit with the calls, with making the reeds, or making an attempt at the reed. But you can do it with the straw and that, but I think I need to go into this in a different way. Probably not working it at all, right? Very basic that one, but complicated business, the reeds. And I'll juke around. I'm hoping to fall upon a nice, simple, easy way to do it that could be adapted easily. But I think you've got to understand a lot more about it than I do before you, the chances of that happening, like, you know. So, but the whistles, mine got some fancy cord to put on them. One or two people that will be getting them as a gift more than anything. So, but they work really well actually. Very surprised how well they work, and so very little in them. Cost me more for the cord yesterday. I was down at the Bosun's Locker at Port Edgar. Big differences down there now, it's all cleared out, and we only got a decent road in and out of it, what a difference that would make. But I always like boats and water. It's like the caravanette, like the camper vans, I suppose. I keep looking at them, there's a couple of beauties down there for sale right now, but oh dear, I don't think I'd have trouble, I'm bad enough on tarmac, God knows what I'd be like in wonderful water. But you can't look at it, it's treat for your mind. I think I may introduce a little bit of stain to this and still it down a little bit. But I've also been popping, I came back from the church and I think it was a therapy thing. I said, oh, I stick two or three sticks. Like the chap today was telling me where to get some more hazel, where to get some good hazel. So I think that might be a venture for tomorrow. But pop a few together. You always return to the thing you like. Some work well. You think they work at the time, but when you go back to them, you go, But, as I say, there'll be a hand for them all, I think. And the sticks are there, and the handles are there, so it pleases me to do it. So, this one I put a little brass collar in. Just a wee bit of detail. Same again, I won't throw anything away. The brass to go to the scrap there, and inside the fittings and whatnot, there's these brass rings, and so so I won't throw that. I'll have them and all put it like the son keeps throwing it out, and I keep piling it in. And another week there, he's cleared out a lot of stuff too. And I said, wait till I'm in the house first before you do it. I'm at that age when it's really good. I can't remember what the hell I've got. If I see it go out the door, I go, oh, well. But if I don't see it, then there's a good chance that I won't remember that I had it in the first place. And as I say, there's stuff in here that I'll never see the light of day again. I'll never get round to seeing it again. I put it by with a thought to using it, but I can't even remember what I've got. But we're going to have a little shot at making the reed, but I don't know. It's, we'll see. As I said, we might just fall upon it. And anyway, times went. But that was just to bring it up on a stick, and quite happy with that. Good for. I think probably I should treat it a lot better. But if you've got a stick, do treat it a lot better. Do clean it down. Don't have it standing out in all weathers, if possible. Anyway, and. As I said, I make hangers up, make hangers for them, and you can hang them up on that. So anyway, leave it at that. We'll catch you later. Cheers.